मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, टुडे वी आर डूइंग इंग्लिश बाल भारती फ्रॉम यूनिट 1 लेसन नंबर 7. बिफोर डूइंग दिस लेसन चिल्ड्रेन, आई विल बी टेलिंग यू अबाउट कन्वर्जेशन बिकॉज दिस लेसन इज बेस्ड ऑन कन्वर्जेशन. सो लेट्स सी द मीनिंग ऑफ कन्वर्जेशन. टू टॉक बिटवीन टू और मोर पीपल इन विच थॉट्स एंड फीलिंग्स एंड आइडियाज आर एक्सप्रेस्ड. Questions are based and answered, or news and information is expressed. An informal, usually private talk in which two or more people exchange thoughts, feelings or ideas, or in which news or information is given or discussed. An example of a conversation is two friends talking while having lunch together. We will see the importance of conversation. Conversations are key to language development. The exchange of the thoughts and ideas and listening to each other. People learn by hearing each other's thoughts while observing facial and body expressions that show emotions. So children, now we will start this lesson. But children, I hope you have understood the meaning of conversation. So children, shall we start this lesson? Our lesson is, let's speak. Come on children, let's speak, let's talk. In this picture, we are listening, we are repeating, and we are enacting. Listen means to hear, repeat means to repeat the same lines again and again. Enact means to act. So children, in this lesson, there are two characters, Ashwini and her mother. Ashwini, she is a small girl. She is also studying in your class, children. She is asking some question to her mother. So in this picture, you can see, this is her mother. Can you see, children? Very good. So see this small girl, how she is asking her mother. She is asking her mother politely some question, children. See children, even you also, when you are tired at home doing all your work, and then even you ask permission, no? Yes. So the permission, how you asked to your mother? Very politely, yes. So notice the lines in the first character, children, that every conversation is similar to all of the, in all of the lines. So the word may I is a request for asking any questions. So children, I tell you, every time when you are talking to someone, to your elders, you should ask politely. Okay? So children, I hope you understood whatever I am telling. So children, in this picture, you will see this small little girl, very politely she is asking. So children, let's read what Ashwini is telling. May I go out to play? I, see children, I means mother. May I go out to play? I, Ashwini is asking to her mother. In this picture you can see children, Ashwini, she is a small little girl and raising her hand, and she is asking her mother. Her mother, you can see in this picture. Yes. Let's see what Ashwini is asking. May I go out to play? I. So may is used to speak in a polite manner, children. It is used to ask permission or request by sharing one or two sentences as examples. So children, we will see the examples also. So Our example is, may I go out to play? May I go out to play? So let's see some examples for may I. May I borrow your book? Yes, children. Okay, very good. May I sit next to you? May I borrow your eraser? See, children, whenever we are in the classroom, all these questions you ask to your friends. Whenever you need something, same way here Ashwini is also asking her mother. So I told you, children, few examples for may I. So children, let's see what Ashwini's mother is replying. Yes, you may. What Ashwini's mother is telling? Yes, you may. So now you can see in this picture Ashwini and her mother. What Ashwini is asking? Politely she is asking her mother the question, may I go out to play? And what mother is, I is telling? Yes, you may. So children, whenever you are asking some questions politely, that is in may I form, so your answer you are getting also in a correct, politely manner. So children, in this way, children, you listen, you repeat and enact. So children, there are some sentences also, children, that you have to do on your own. Okay, so children, there are also may I request sentences are there, and there are also make sentences also there. So children, let's continue in our next topic.